Hello. Today I want to go through how to take a compass bearing from a map using a compass. Now, this may be slightly different to the way you've done it before or what you're used to, because most people take a compass bearing from a map with a compass, whereas I said using a compass. And that means using all the compass's inbuilt features. In a previous video, I said if you keep things simple, they're much less likely to go wrong. So this is another one of those videos. I'm going to keep everything really, really simple, and hopefully that's the way forward. You'll need to watch the whole of the video if you want to know how to do it properly, but you know, that's totally up to you. For this video, I'll be using one of these, a basic Silver 4, Expedition 4, which is probably the most common type of compass which is used by trekkers and hill walkers. And if it isn't, it should be. Let me get a map. I'll also be using a 1:25 map, 1:25,000, which is another very standard scale used by trekkers and hill walkers. 1:25, 1:24, it's virtually the same. Now, I know this type of stuff has been shown millions of times on videos before, but hopefully you'll find out how to do it properly now. So if you've been doing it a different way previously, then just compare the way I show you to the way you've done it before. So I'll take this map out and I'll drop it onto this stone, and what we'll do is we'll talk through it and I'll go through it stage by stage. I'm going to assume that we are here where it's indicated on your screen with a big black arrow, that we are here where the Pennine Bridleway junctions with a wall, and we are going to go in a straight line across the country rather than following the meandering path of the Bridleway. We're going to go in a straight line across the country to where the Bridleway goes to another wall. Now, just as a thing, I'm going to be using the parallax line on this compass. So in other words, I'll be putting this black line on where I am and where I want to go to. If you don't have a parallax line on your compass, you can always use the edge of the compass. So just put the edge of the compass on where you are and where you want to go to. Now, an important point to note here is make sure that it's the edge of the compass that's facing you, never the one that's furthest away, and that'll prevent any parallax errors. If you're not used to that phrase, I'm sure just Google parallax errors and you'll get lots of information about it. It's all to do with how you're looking at something and the angle that you're looking at something. Anyway, I'll stop waffling now. I do that a lot. What I'll do, let's get back to the map. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to put the line on where I am and where I want to go to. And the next thing I'm going to remember is that I'm going to place the dial so that it's actually touching, or it's over one of the eastings on the map, which is the blue vertical lines. So here we are. So the dial is now over one of the blue vertical lines. Okay. Now the reason for that is, I'll show you in a minute, what we can do is we can actually use the orienting lines in the middle of the dial to make sure that we get a very precise bearing. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to rotate the dial until the arrow is pointing straight up the map, in other words at grid north, and I'm going to check that I've got it correct by comparing the orienting lines to the blue vertical line on the map. That way that I know that I've got a very precise bearing. And I see that here my bearing is 114 degrees. Okay, so I've got 114 degrees here. Now, I'm not making any adjustments for magnetic declination. If you live in an area where you have to make adjustments for this, it's really simple to do. I've made another video. Sorry, there are grouse and wild grouse having fights literally just behind the camera. So hopefully, I think the large male is winning against the two smaller males at the moment, who knows. Anyway, I've made another video about magnetic declination and how to cope with it really simply. I'll put the link in the description box. So that's how you take a compass bearing from a map. So let's do another example. Let's let's say we're at the, I'll put this back onto your screen again, here we go. So let's say we're at the junction of, let's pick a point, these three walls here, and I want to go, for some reason, to the slight bend in the contour line on Kirby Fell. So I'll highlight those on your screen. So once again, I put the parallax line, so it's where I am and where I want to go, so it's above those. The direction of travel arrow on the compass is pointing in the right direction. And then I again rotate the dial until the arrow is pointing straight up at grid north. And I check this by comparing the orienting lines inside the dial with the blue vertical lines. And that's how you take a bearing from a map to a compass using the inbuilt features of that, you know, that they're actually in most decent quality compasses. So next thing, you've got your bearing, how do you follow it? How do you get from here to somewhere else that you might not be able to see? So let's just go through how to follow a compass bearing. So you now know what your compass bearing should be from what you, the work you've just done with your map. So how do you actually follow that without getting lost or without becoming navigationally challenged? Is that a good way? We've all done it, don't worry. Anyway, so what we're going to do is, the first thing with your compass is don't put it around your neck like this and try and do this sort of stuff. It's never gonna work. For now, what I want you to do is take your compass off, hold it in front of you, and then set your bearing. Let's say you set your bearing at 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to set my bearing at 1, 2, 3. Then all I'm going to do is, rather than trying to point the compass and see which way it goes, I'm simply going to rotate my whole body until the needle is directly over the arrow. That's the idea of holding it in this position, because I can look down and I can actually check that the needle is directly over the arrow, and I can also look at the direction arrow on the compass and I can see where I'm going to go. So once you've done this, hold it steady and just rotate your body, keep it nice and solid, and then look along the direction arrow and you can actually see the direction that you'll be traveling. Now, to walk from here to something that you've chosen on a map, if you can see what it is you've chosen, I don't know, the summit of a hill or something, and you can see the entire route, then take your bearing, look at the mountain and off you go. You don't need a compass from here. Most of the time you can't see the entire route, so you're going to have to follow a bearing. And the way you do that is find something that is between you and your destination and walk to that. And then if you still can't see your destination, find something else. And you keep leapfrogging, and each time you arrive, you take another bearing. That was a bit of a waffle, but I'll explain. Try and explain that simpler. Let's say that I'm here and I want to go to something that's, I don't know, 500 meters away. What I'll do is I'll choose something that's directly in line between me and my destination. It might be a large rock or a noticeable lump of grass or something, and I'll walk to that. What I won't do is I won't walk down the road staring at my compass. Once you've decided where you're going to walk to, set off, and then when you arrive at whatever it is you're going to, get your compass out again, find something else, another intermediate point to walk to, and you keep doing that all the way until you actually arrive at your destination. So that's how you take a bearing from a map using a compass and its inbuilt features, and that's how you follow a bearing. So quick recap, if you've got parallax lines on your compass, use them. If you don't have, then use the edge of your compass, but try and use the edge of the compass that's facing you. Make sure that the dial is over one of the eastings, the vertical lines on the map, so that when you're rotating the dial on the map, you can actually use the orienting lines in the center of the dial to check that you've got a very precise bearing. Once you've taken your bearing and you come to follow it, hold the compass at chest height, keep it nice and solid, keep it in front of you, rotate your whole body until the needle is directly over the arrow. Don't
take a bearing off something that's, say, right, I'm going to walk to something on the horizon, because you'll take an arced footpath and you'll miss it. Find something that is between you and your destination, that is in a direct line, and walk to that. Then take your compass out and do exactly the same again. And you keep doing that in stages until you reach your destination. So hopefully that was informative. That's it. Thanks for watching.